Revelation 2 and 10. Fear none of those things which thou shalt suffer. Behold, the devil shall cast some of you into prison, that ye may be tried, and ye shall have tribulation 10 days. Be thou faithful unto death, and I will give thee a crown of life.
That faith, we mentioned in Revelation 3 and 10, Revelation 3 and 10, say, he that kept the word of my patience. Patience also means faith, being faithful. Then, and regardless of what you go through, then you still remain
patient.
On mission. Still remain faithful, yeah? Still remain focused on your Bashem Yashai for doing what you're supposed to do. See? So, the most I will give, I have the spirit of faith upon the leg, upon the leg. Man, we out here, we are hopeful in the leg. Hope to be that those men, part of those men, yo, 144,000. Then, which is the coming government, which gonna rule the earth next, man. Then, Yahweh Yahweh Shai, whoever passed King David, then and down. Then that's what we look for. We look for some with things with substance, yo. Then, and we're not like them people anywhere. We look fun to be Oh, may I be the next track star? May I be the next footballer? May I be artist? Then I will sing some song. Them things are trivial. Then, but them say, yo, we about the precept again.
2 and 10?
Mm-hmm. No, not 2 and 10. 2 and 10.
Revelation 2 and 10. Fear none of those things which thou shalt suffer. Behold, the devil shall cast some of you into prison, that ye may be tried, and ye shall have tribulation 10 days. Be thou faithful unto death, and I will give thee a crown of life.
Yeah, because even when the world I lose, I bug out, then we are gonna face it too. But the thing we're different with we from them people here is that we are gonna have the faith of Yahweh Bashem Yashai. Then
wisdom and knowledge, man.
We believe say Yahweh Bashem Yashai protect we. Then that are the difference. Them people are not gonna know what this faith. Them are gonna doubt say even Jesus exists, man.
Them so-called Jesus.
So-called Savior. Them are believe. What them believe in, just like what Albert Pike said. Then say how the level thing roughly properly like the level castle them are bring up on the world, people are gonna doubt say there's a God. Yeah, something along that line.
Believe there's a God, but don't believe in a God as a belief.
Then, them have a clue. You know, them daily life is just social media and fun and games. That's how them daily life, so they don't know what's coming. So when you tell them what come, then, sir. You're from a bad me, so God, I come.
I'm in my time,
I'm gonna build my house.
And like, you know, the dark horse, they come, the five foolish virgins, they will not have no high.
But this is the thing. Niggas not take check until something happen.
Can.
Yo. When earth, you know the moment, for example, you know the moment when the earth are shaped, then fear. But after the earth kick pass, yeah man, fun and games, man, meme to kill. Then, meme left, right, and center, it's all good, it's all joke. So you know the moment, because that's why it's going to be a season of terror, man. It's going to be a season of terror. No, something like that is happening, huh? You know what I mean? Everything good all of a sudden. No, it's gonna be a season of terror and millions gonna die, man.
I appreciate that, brother.
Go on.
Hosea 5 and 15, I will go and return to my place till they acknowledge their offense and seek my face. In their affliction, they will seek me early.
Yeah. Common example, it happened commonly among our people, man. Yeah, man, bad one. Jesus! Yeah. Oh, God! Is it? When? When I'm in a trouble.
God.
Then, yo, a toothache will lick a nigga and a nigga start bawling for God, man.
Done.
Oh God, oh God.
Right. Who start praying? Who start praying like them, man, when they get sentenced?
Exactly.
I tell you. Yeah. All of a sudden, you're the member of God.
Hey, as your pastor, I say, your pastor Ramlop say, when they go to prison, they find religion.
Yeah, man.
You see me?
Who not come out Muslim?
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
So, about Proverbs 1 and verse 23 and down, it say, turn you up my reproof. Behold, I will pour my spirit unto you, and I will make known my words unto you. And I'm going to do that right now, doing prophets, yo. Because I have called and he refused, I have stretched out my hand and no man regarded.
Yeah.
But you have set at naught all my counsel and with none of my reproof. I will laugh at your calamity. Mock when your fear cometh. Right? When your fear cometh as a desolation and your destruction as a whirlwind,
yeah.
When distress and anguish come upon you, then shall they call upon me, but I will not answer. They shall seek me early, but they shall not find me.
Right? And that word anguish means severe pain. So, yo, them kind of pain, yeah? Like a worse than belly pain. Worse than toothache.
Worse than liver pain.
Worse than liver pain. Yeah, all right.
Scripture always talk about a woman in travail.
Yo, but yo, you can say, no? You have a woman who say, yo, oh, them feel. Yo, we carry for 9 months and labor pain and the worst pain, so you have to respect. Well, there's a level of pain we're going to surpass that, man. And you're going to go through that for a season. Then, you're going to go through hunger. Then the lack of food, no food.
The calamities.
Then till the ribcage them start show. Then they're going to be that serious.
They have to start feeding for your own family.
Yeah. You start hallucinate. Parasite them start act up in the helical body. Yo, you have in London, 700 women, woman. 700 women.
So them
run 10k in a demand that we are alone.
Some naked as a man.
Well, showing body confidence, man. But watch this.
See? Sorry,
the soon. Yeah, see? Them a run up and down naked in London showing body confidence. Then, lack of morality, yo. But when the famine come, then, all of that, man, people say, yo, wailing shall be in our street. And rise up the women that are at ease.
Gun.
Those women are at ease, man. Zin? Yeah, them are on bait. They might be prayed upon, man.
Alright.
Zin? Go on.
Jeremiah 9 and verse 17. Thus saith the Lord of hosts, consider ye and call for the mourning women that they may come, and send for cunning women that they may come. Oh, you look up the word cunning, the footnote there is. Skillful wailing women.
Skillful in wailing.
You see me? And let them make haste and take up a wailing for us, that our eyes may run down with tears and our eyelids gush out with waters. For a voice of wailing is heard out of Zion. How are we spoiled? We are greatly confounded because we are forsaken the land, because our dwellings have cast us out. Yet hear the word of the Lord, O ye women, and let your ear receive the word of his mouth.
Yeah.
And teach your daughters wailing and every one of her neighbor lamentation. For death is come up into our windows and is entered into our palaces.
Right.
To cut off the children from without and the young men from the streets. Speak, thus saith the Lord, even the carcasses of men shall fall as dung upon the open field and as the handful of the harvest man, and none shall gather them.
Right, so everybody have got peace. Chaos and beat. Scripture say what? Death has come up to our windows.
Go on.
Meaning, you have people going to die then around you. You're going to suffer, going through all the tribulation and anguish. Then, the death angel them. Then, just like in the movie, I have a Bird Box. Just by the sight of them alone, you have people that freak out and die, man. Based upon what they see. So hey, skipper say your wailing shall be in our streets.
Yeah, just like what I mean, a bird back to you, Lord can send spirit just like that, yo.
Yeah.
He telling a wisdom in Solomon 17, yo.
He say, you see?
See, apparition has come to them, yo. Yeah, those are the death angels, yo. Demons, yo. Lord, I got send demons when this thing kick off, yo. See? A lot of people going to die just by fright, yo.
Just by fright.
You see, hey, tell us the minister how to feel them, yo.
Just by evil them here.
Just by evil them here.
Yeah, the priest that say your men are feeling them for that which is coming up on the earth. Sin?
I'm fine with you. So Luke 21 I'm going to start at verse 25. He said, and there shall be signs in the sun and in the moon and in the stars and upon the earth, distress upon distress of nations. And that word distress means a holding together, a narrow place. Distress, anguish, anxiety. You see me? He said, with perplexity. Right, and the word perplexity mean confusion, yo.
Yeah.
You see me?
That's the same thing we said earlier. You have high level of confusion just to take place, you know? That take place in the earth. People don't know what the hell is going on. It's because the earth has got real to and flow like a junkyard.
Right.
The earth has got shake literally, and you got people just going mad, man.
Right.
You see?
Gun. He said, the sea and the waves roaring, men's heart failing them for fear. And for looking after those things which are coming on the earth, for the powers of heaven shall be shaken. See me?
So yeah, so you see the
new place stand and the chariots.
Yeah, yeah, man. So you see who's responsible for that? Who's responsible for bringing that fear upon the earth? The Almighty, the Most High, because people don't fear the Most High, yo. People don't fear the Almighty.
Gone.
Them take the thing, the words of the Heavenly Father, light. See? Niggas make light of the Bible, them criticize them, do that all sort of madness, them talk against the Bible. Oh, a man write it, and them not understand nothing when the Bible, man. What you learn when a man teach you? What you learn when you self-taught? When somebody around you influence you, or the environment influence you?
Right.
So what you learn when you create?
You think I...
But the Almighty, see? You can use a computer, have so much confidence in a computer where a man create. Zin, and you feel like you believe in either AI or super AI and how amazing it is. Zin, but the Almighty, the man who created all things, man, you despise. Zin, put women over the Most High. Something will bleed every fucking month. Zin, you put over the Almighty.
Worship the creature.
You worship the creature more than the creator. That's why death is coming to this place, man. Zin. And the society well deserve it, man.
Right. This is Zephaniah 1 and 11. Holy inhabitants of Maktesh. And Maktesh is a town in Jerusalem.
Right.
He said, for all the merchant people are cut down. So that's for all people, yo.
Right.
And all they that bear silver are cut off.
Right.
Right. So the brother there say, yo, you have brothers, you have niggas that drive by, seeing in them fancy cars and them in them nice jobs. And them have money, like the Jay-Z and Beyonce and all these different people in our nation. We exalted, yo. He said, all they that bear silver are cut off.
Right.
And it shall come to pass at that time that I will search Jerusalem with candles and punish the men that are settled on their lees, that say in their heart, the Lord will not do good, neither will he do evil.
Yeah. I mean, not do nothing.
Right, they can't. That means not nothing. Him not exist. Pretty much.
Many of them comfort zone.
Right.
Yeah, when you look up lees, that's somewhere make wine ferment. Good. You see me, I say, and the second lung in the
bottle. The second right, lung in the
bottle. Yeah, jigs. And the jigs, the second lung in the bottle, and the lung, they relax. But they get disturbed, man. Right. You know, like when you shake up, you see jigs in the bottle, and you shake it up, and everything
is moving.
As opposed to shake this place, man. And everything I get move up, man. See?
Verse 13. Therefore, their goods shall be a booty, and their houses a desolation. They shall also build houses. But not inhabit them.
What do word a booty mean again?
Spoil.
Alright, let's look it up. Yeah. Where booty mean a spoil or plunder.
Hey, them woman. Because them woman are them booty, man. Zin? Sorry, read back the definition again.
Alright, read the definition again. I'm bring it up back. It say plunder or spoil.
Right. So them woman with them have are coming for booty. Men are gonna use them for spoils, man. Zin? As their brother or the elder Malcolm. I'll bring out in our video. Yo, women are gonna use just to get past checkpoint, man. And you better look good.
Right.
Because you know, look good.
Can't.
You're gonna get used, you're gonna get caught as spoiled.
Trading.
And get used for trading, man. Women gonna be used for trading just right. To get past checkpoints.
Money now got no value in those days.
No value. Body confident, you get fucked.
The scripture read, brother,
see,
say,
there
was
so much confidence you
gonna
have in that body there, man.
Right.
See?
Hey, just to prove that, it's Isaiah 13 and verse 16. He said, their children also shall be dashed to pieces before their eyes.
Yeah.
Their houses shall be spoiled and their wives ravished.
Yeah, men of our nation, women gonna get dealt with as such, man.
God.
Because the Eden, especially when them Japanese come over, men or them Russians, Yo, women can get raped left, right, and center, man, when this thing come down, man.
Right.
You're talking about, yo, how they raping and killing our women. You tell, yo, you don't see nothing yet.
Yeah, yeah,
when them Soviet troops come over in America, Zane, madmen spare none. When them Soviet, yeah? You ain't, yeah, right. Cause it, yeah, right. Especially the UN troops. Because the UN, basically, when the skipper say, when he calls it all, both small and great, I would say, anyone who worship the beast and image, he calls them to get put to death, or that they should be killed. That at the time, when the UN troops basically are going through and patrolling through the streets of America and catching people, throwing them in concentration camp, then, and forcing them to take the chip.
Quarantine.
Hey, this is definitely 1 and 13 again. Therefore, their goods shall become a booty, and their houses a desolation. They shall also build houses, but not inhabit them. They shall plant vineyards, but not drink the wine thereof. The great day of the Lord is near. It is near and hasted greatly. Even the voice of the day of the Lord.
Right. So you got people, women, a chim off their head to look like man, just because they don't want to get preyed upon. See?
And a tape down them breasts.
A tape down all them breasts.
Ugly
and
girl
pat, and pat themselves.
Ugly girl like get put to death quick. I can't
yeah,
chill
yeah,
with them.
Yeah, ugly one them dead quick. And the one them look so.
Right. He said the mighty man shall cry there bitterly.
Yeah.
Right? That day. So if the mighty man a cry bitterly, what he said the woman them?
Exactly.
See?
Yeah, the one them said them a bad man and them a done. The military, the ones in the military, in the police force. Then. Yo, them a cry like girl, man.
Soldier.
Yeah, soldier them, especially when them go over there in the Valley of Jehoshaphat and the war in the Valley of Jehoshaphat get kick off. Then skipper say, yo, them are weird, them are bad.
Right.
Then them are crime.
He said that day is a day of wrath, a day of trouble and distress, a day of wasteness and desolation,
yeah.
A day of darkness and gloominess,
God.
A day of clouds and thick darkness. And they have trumpet and alarm against the fortified cities and against the high walls and high towers. And I will bring distress upon men, and they shall walk like blind men, because they have sinned against the Lord, and their blood shall be poured out as dust, and their flesh as the dung.
Right.
Neither shall their gold nor their silver be able to deliver them in the day of the Lord's wrath, but the whole land shall be devoured by the fire of my jealousy.
Thermonuclear missiles.
Gun.
See them, man. See them. ICBMs. Then this are actually the most I send in the land, man.
Right.
From Iran, from Russia.
From all over the world.
From all over the world.
Even from the EU.
Europe.
Yes.
Right.
Europe.
Your brother say your EU.
Right.
Then.
For he shall make even a speedy riddance of all them that dwell in the land.
Right, including our people too. So the heathen, along with our people, are cut off with that fire, man. The wicked are our people. See? Because 2/3 of our people wicked as hell, man. Love being faggots, love being lesbian, love eating abominable food. See? It's gonna be a joyful day when them faggots start to get put to death, man. And them lesbians. Start get put to death, and the wicked basically in general, yo.
And as you say lesbian, enough of them lesbian are going like man, and them days of them are going to see the man act.
Yeah.
You see me?
What?
Have some?
Yeah, man. Alright. 2 Ezra chapter 16 and verse 67. Behold, God himself is the judge. Fear him. Leave off from your sins.
Right.
And forget your iniquities.
Right.
Man, that's a warning for the elect, though. The one them who have the ears to hear. Isn't me? The one them who have a big repentance to the sin them when they already commit. Isn't me? Because the scripture say, yo, blessed is the man whom the Lord imputed not iniquity, and blessed is the man whose sins are forgiven him. Right? And that's talking about the elect, yo, and the 1/3. Right? Those are the men who are going to listen to the admonishment of the Lord.
Okay.
Isn't me? And I will leave off from their sin and undertake the baptism, the true baptism and the true cleansing. Is changing your ways, you are learning this truth, right? What?
To meddle no more with them forever.
Right, meddle no more with them who? Meaning the other nations, yo. Meddle no more with Esau's philosophy. Meddle no more with the Eastern nations' philosophy, yo. Meddle no more with 2/3. You see me? Come out of this society, we promote transsexuality, you see me, homosexuality, bestiality. So we promote adultery, idolatry, all the different things that, you see me, we promote self-love and excessive self-worth.
Yeah, yeah.
You see me? Separate yourself from that, you're only the elect are gonna hear that warning, you know? What?
To meddle no more, right? With them forever. So shall God lead you forth and deliver you from all trouble.
Right, so those elect will listen, right? Are gonna get delivered from all trouble, all of the things them we hear we speak about. You see me? What the scriptures I speak about, which is the time of Jacob's trouble, you see me? Which is the same time of trouble written off in Daniel chapter 12, right? But it said Jacob shall be delivered out of it, yo. You see me?
That's what I say too.
Can. Right? So he said he shall lead them to it, yo, and deliver them from all the trouble, yo. What? Right.
Far behold, the burning wrath of a great multitude is kindled over you.
Right?
And they shall take away certain of you. And feed you and being idle with things offered unto idols.
Right. That burning rod is the rod of the so-called white man, yo. Right? The red Hebrew Edomite, let's label him correctly. The red Hebrew Edomite.
Revelation 12 and 12.
We're here to it from the day when, you know, him sell his birthright to you, from the day when him despise his birthright and sell it, yo. Right, the scripture tells us, yo, he kept his rod perpetually, yo. Right, he never dropped him rod.
Gone.
Right, so if I go come and if I go take some of it, see me, some of our people, seeing and feed with things offered unto idols, yo. Talking about the RFID microchip, yo. Forcing some of our people to forget take it, yo. Right, and just like what I'm doing at the time of Greek captivity, force some of them to import just
Eleazar.
Before that, yo. Eleazar, the seven sons and the mother.
Gone.
You see me? At least Elias are, you know, they get
him, big give him leave an example for us.
Yeah. What?
I said, for behold, the burning wrath of a great multitude is kindled over you.
Right.
And they shall take away certain of you and feed you, being idle with things offered unto idols.
Hey, them gunmen, yeah. If you like say, so, them are the gun, my baddest thing. Hey. When UN troops and Russian troops and whichever troops running from them blows and skirts, you know, man, we actually have military training. When mortar shells and them shit their fire off of them, you see me? Them time, them gonna know, say, yo, the little whatever what them have is nothing, yo.
Drones.
Drones. When drones are carry out tactical strikes, yo.
Man, you have suicide with them too. Yeah, suicide, yo, it's a movie we see it, you know. Them bomb up themselves, them just.
Yeah, they're flying and exposed.
Yeah, they're flying and exposed.
You see me, so. Hey,
even this regular Jamaican military. I'm checking one thing. Jamaican military, then can't manage.
Hey, but then they can help you that in the valley.
No, but outside of that. It's like regular. If any good man, let's say a soldier, he might take for himself. They prefer to fight the police them more than the soldier.
Done.
You see me? And if the Jamaican defense force, where under trained, under equipped.
Underfunded. What if it's the UN troops? Right. What if it's the Russian troops? Them man, they were hardened, battle hardened by the cold and everything.
China, I'll come here. With the military.
Alright. And they that consent unto them shall be had in derision and in reproach and trodden underfoot. For there shall be in every place and in the next cities, a great insurrection upon those that fear the Lord.
Right, so Esau will come up against the prophets, yo. Right, and some brothers, you know, are going to glorify Yahweh Hashem Yahshua in death. And scripture telling that, be fearful unto death, and I will give thee a crown of life. So you have some brothers going to die, yo. Right, but at the same time when them die, I'm going to wake up in them chariots, yo. Coming down in a glorious body, yo. Ready for dish out the vengeance of the Lord, yo. And the scripture say, yo, with my people Israel, I'm gonna lay vengeance upon Edom, yo. You see me? So, hey, any brother, you see me, we're gonna face that. Any brother of the elect, we're gonna face that. They might face that with pride, yo. Right? They might face it with honor. You say honor. They might face it with honor, yo. You see me? Eagerness. Because I must say, yo, as soon as me lock me eye, me wake up back in a perfect body. Coming down to the show the vengeance of Yahweh Hashem Yahweh. Coming down with an angelic force, yo.
Gone.
What?
So back in 2 Ezra 16 and verse
71. They shall be like madmen, sparing none, but still spoiling and destroying those that fear the Lord.
Right. Like we see a lot of some of our people are get put to death, yo. Right? But this body, this is not it, yo. Right? Leaving this body is not it. Matter of fact, all of we have to go change the body, yo. And not change your body is technically death, yo. One.
Verse 72. For they shall be waste and take away their goods and cast them out of their houses. Then shall they be known who are my chosen.
Right.
And they shall be tried as the gold in the fire. Hear, O ye, my beloved, saith the Lord. Behold, the days of trouble are at hand, but I will deliver you from the same.
Right, as the elder Ariel are going up recently, you know, and other elders, other apostles going up recently, other brothers going up recently. You see me? Now at the time to spiritually prep you. Right? Now at the time to build your spiritual arsenal, you. You see me?
When the elder Ariel said, get it while it's available.
While it's available, you. You see me? Build up your strength, your spiritual strength while it's available, yo. Like scripture say, yo, wisdom and knowledge shall be the stability of thy times and strength of salvation, yo. Right? And if you look up the word stability, you go back to the Hebrew word amawana, which is faith, yo. Right? So wisdom and knowledge shall be the faith, you know, of thy time, yo. Because the more you know the precepts, the more you rehearse the precepts, the more you live in it, and the firmer you feel, can. Right? And as the Elder Shapur out here always say, yo, now at the time to test the Lord, yo. Now at the time to pray for certain things, right? And witness the Lord deliver it to you, yo. So that you can have that confidence, knowing that you ask the most of things continually, and continually in give you things, yo. Because every time you ask the most of something, you get it, that increase your faith, yo. So you know, so in that time, right? You're gonna have that full confidence, you know, so yo, if you ask him for something, he's gonna deliver you, yo.
Which man
have some bread and we're going to give
stone.
God. Right. And if you tell Yahushua also tell you, he say, yo, whatever you pray in my name,
yes,
you shall receive, yo.
Ask and you shall receive, yo. Yeah.
You see me? So it have to be second nature for your instinct be to pray whenever you come in a difficult situation, yo. And it's a habit that we can be cultivated, yo.
Yeah, and just to add, what do you mean the brothers like a reason? I mean, never they are too pretty, too bad, but right now the ack have a full head of ear. You see me? Full head of ear, and I just pray the ack prayer.
Oh, a little
you see?
Miracle
that? Yeah.
In disguise, obviously.
Yeah, you know?
Yeah, man, oh, a little miracle. Testimony saying the most I work.
John.
Hey, the thing is, you know, all I need to do is do the thing that you have to do, you know. You see me? Elder brother, they said that to me a few years back. He said, brother, as long as you're doing the will of the Most High, as long as you're doing your videos, you're sincere toward brothers, you're sincere toward the Most High, I'm going to take care of you. Yeah, you have got through difficult times, that's a part of it. You see me? Because without the difficult time, there's no way to purge you. You see me? We have to purge away the undesirable characteristics that we have. And now that if you purge away all that, you need adversity. So it's necessary, but at the same time, the Lord are going to take care of you, yo. You see me? The Lord never are going to give you more than you can bear, yo.